Before the campus of Johnson County Community College was built, the landscape was cultivated for corn and alfalfa. But before that, rain that fell on the undeveloped land seeped into the ground to recharge the groundwater or meandered through a series of small streams and into the Indian Creek watershed a mile south of campus. Today, the campus is paved with 2 million square feet of parking and driving surfaces, creating an impermeable seal over the landscape. Rainwater is now directed by curbs into storm drains and concrete pipes, which carry it more rapidly and directly into Indian Creek.
This ultimately means less water reaching your underground aquifers, flooding due to greater volume of water flowing in concentrated paths, and vehicle and other runoff pollutants entering the watershed. So, what is to be done about these issues at a commuter campus like JCCC, where 14,000 cars enter and leave campus every day? The system contains two bioswales like the one you see here. Curb cuts allow the first flush, or the first 1.4 inches of rainfall, to enter the system at this early point for extra treatment.
This initial flow contains 90% of any pollutants that have collected on the pavement. These gravel filters will help to catch most litter before it enters the system, and also to slow down the flow of water as it enters the bioswale. There are 23 different plant species throughout the system. 50,000 individual plants in all will naturally absorb pollutants from the water. Another bonus for native plants is that they are best adapted for surviving in our Kansas climate, needing no additional watering, fertilizers, or mowing to maintain. Beneath the native plants is 24 inches of engineered soils, layers of soil, compost, clay, and sand that promote more water entering the groundwater.
Across the street, you will see one of the system's two manufactured filtration units. These are an example of a technology that will achieve the same result as the larger bioswales, but in a much smaller space. A series of sediment trapping chambers does the work here. Back in the bioswale, water that does not percolate into the soil makes its way into the bioretention cell, where a subsurface drainage system will control the seepage of water, allowing the plants to do their work without letting the water stand too long in the bioswales.
The green wicks in the bioretention cell direct the seeping water back into the original concrete drainage system so that it will rejoin the rest of the rainfall in the vegetated submerged bed, the final stop on our tour. This forebay at the mouth of the original concrete pipe is outlined with limestone boulders to slow the fast and concentrated flow of rainwater and to catch any additional litter. From here, water is introduced into this constructed wetland. An 18-inch layer of gravel underneath the basin holds water for extended cleaning by plant roots and bacteria. The maintained water will also help keep the plant life alive in periods of severe drought. Should water fill the wetland, extended dry detention basins will detain and treat the water as levels gradually lower.
This project was grant-funded through the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act, in addition to a significant contribution from the Johnson County Community College student green fee and from the college itself. The JCCC Stormwater Management Project is just one way the campus is taking responsibility for its overall environmental footprint, and this system allows us to make a cleaner contribution to the watershed.